Welcome to SEL Manufacturing. All SEL electronic devices are made in the USA, and today we're taking a tour of our primary manufacturing facility located at our company headquarters in Pullman, Washington. Our manufacturing mission is to safely deliver defect-free products quickly as promised. It all starts with a blank circuit board. The boards go through several initial steps, including stencil machines and glue machines, to prep them for the rest of the process. From there, the boards are fed into the pick-and-place machines. These machines pick parts from the reels and place them on the board. Parts can be as small as the tip of a ballpoint pen and as big as a half dollar. Pick-and-place machines at SEL place more than 1 million parts per day. Up next is the reflow oven. The oven operates at temperatures of up to 500 degrees. As the board goes through the oven, it is heated and the parts sink into place as the solder melts. This forms an electrical connection with the board. The 10 chambers in the oven allow the board to heat up gradually, avoiding any warping or damage to the circuit boards. After boards come out of the reflow oven, they go directly to the Automated Optical Inspection Machine, or AOI. This machine provides a high-speed, high-resolution camera inspection. It checks every detail of the board to make sure everything is correct. It checks things like part number, misplaced or missing parts, polarity, and insufficient solder, checking up to 118 data points per second. Some complex boards have more than 4,000 points to be checked. The AOI checks all of those in 36 seconds. This process lowers the number of defects that get passed on down the line. By having such a detailed check at the end of every line, we maintain a very short feedback loop, preventing any mistakes which could have large ramifications across the floor. If there is a mistake, it is identified and can be dealt with quickly. Before we automated the process of picking, placing, and soldering parts on boards, assemblers would do these tasks by hand. The parts used to be sorted in muffin tins and hand-soldered. As you will see, many of our manufacturing processes have been automated, but machines are not replacing people at SEL. Our growth and innovation mean that there are always more opportunities for work, learning, and career growth. At this point, the parts have been placed and soldered on the surface of the board. This next set of machines are called through-hole machines. They're placing parts with wires that poke through the board before being trimmed and clinched on the other side so that the part can't fall off. If you turned the board upside down, those parts wouldn't fall out, but they are still fairly loose. These parts will still need to be soldered and fixed to the board. These machines can place up to 19,000 parts per hour. After the through-hole machines, the boards are loaded into the odd-form machine. Just like the name says, this machine places parts that have an odd form. The pieces placed here vary, and this machine can pick up and place a wide variety of different shaped pieces. While these machines are much more versatile, that comes at the cost of speed. They place only one part every 2 to 4 seconds. This still saves us time because it frees up our workers to perform other tasks. These boards are then taken to the progressive assembly line where the final parts are added to the board. The folks here are placing parts on the boards that the machines cannot place. And it's one area where our employee owners' commitment to quality is on display. The units are passed down the assembly line as each assembler adds different components. Electronic work instructions provide visual indicators to ensure accuracy, and each person checks the previous person's work. The board is basically complete, except for the final solder. In the wave solder machine, the board is pulled over the molten solder and the solder flows up into the holes, creating a solid electrical connection. This machine holds about 1,500 pounds of molten solder, and after passing through the machine, all parts are now soldered to the board. Up next is board level test, where we perform a range of tests prior to putting the boards into a chassis. Circuit and component characterization test is where we verify that all components on the board are in the correct place. Functional test is where we power up the board, check the overall functionality of it, and download any necessary firmware that is required. We have several different types of stations and programs we use to ensure that every board we build is of the highest quality. Now that we've built and tested the boards, we move on to assembling the units. Each unit must be built, tested, and packaged. Utilizing the philosophy of world-class manufacturing, we switched from a batched build process to flow lines, each focused on a specific product family. These flow lines reduced the time and travel distance in the assembly process. It is easier to keep track of individual units and orders, and mistakes can be identified much sooner. We can quickly trace an error in a unit back to the exact cause, preventing repeat errors, and production for a single type can be sped up or slowed down based on orders without affecting the rest of the factory and other unit types. The use of flow lines has greatly improved quality and lead times, with most product families going from a 14-day lead time to a 5-day lead time, with more than 99% shipping on time. While the speed and flexibility of the flow lines has lowered lead times, we do keep some of our high-demand units on inventory in our ship-from-stock department. Units in this area often ship to our customers the next day. This has also allowed us to do some incredible things, like overnight shipping a product to a customer for next day installation during disaster recovery efforts. The final stop on this factory tour is the product hospital. We design our products to last more than 20 years. However, should a product failure occur, we encourage our customers to return the product for root cause analysis. Our goal is to understand the cause of a failure and repair or replace the unit within 72 hours of receipt, whether it meets our 10-year warranty or not. We analyze the data from product returns to rapidly improve our products going forward. This helps us continue to better our understanding about what our products must endure in the field and how we can continue to improve our designs and technology. Thank you for taking the time to tour our manufacturing facility. The products made here help keep the lights on around the world, and we hope you've enjoyed seeing some of the processes and people that make that happen.